Homemade traditional Peruvian dessert, alfajores, basket of ham, beef, turkey, veggie gourmet sandwiches. Hoggy Waste Catering, phone number 778-245-3007.
We want to congratulate you for your assistance to our personal taxes seminar. No doubt, there are many people, immigrants or not, that need to be well informed. Now is tax season, and it's good to know your rights as a resident or citizen. This is your Immigrants Magazine's program, but first, our teaser.
I think it's language. In the beginning, when I came here, the language, you know, the communication with some people, they ask me, I don't know how to answer, I did not even know, you know, the understand.
El portarse bien no está incluido en obtener dinero. A veces los padres les dicen, si te portas bien, terminando te doy dinero, terminando del evento donde vamos, te puedo pagar. No, esto nunca debemos de hacerlo.
We are immigrants, we feel, gee, Canadian system is perfect. It's not, right? So that why it's important for us to be on top of our game, trying to learn as much as we can.
You want it, you get it. Once again, we realized that those huge obstacles are nothing when you really want to accomplish a goal. This is Wendy Nguyen Jung's story. She arrived to Canada in 2005. She didn't know a word of English. In China, she used to be a doctor in traditional Chinese medicine. In Canada, she resumes her career in medicine with success. And between us, she used to study English into the closet, 2 hours daily. Why? She tells her story.
But you know that when I came here, then it was really hard. Yes, and it's some, you know, the language barriers and the communication problem issue. And also, you know, the just like different medication from China, you know, the China and the, you know, the Canada. It's lots of struggle. So, you know, that just like start from basics. You have to introduce yourself to the patient, and you know that introduce the Chinese medicine and the traditional Chinese medicine to the patient, to unfamiliar people. So that is a lot of struggle. The first job as caregiver is hard for me because I was back in China, and just like a doctor, you know, the position. I never, you know, take care of the patient. Just like a take care of the patient, but difference with here. And make me, you know, the really, in the beginning, I'm really feel, not really feel, you know, the, not really feel from my heart, not feel really good. But after I've been take care of them, I've been love of this person, so I'm just like a past that is really hard time. Yes, at one moment it was really hard for me because you know that during daytime I have to work as a caregiver, I take care of them, and during nighttime I only have nighttime study, so I was living the some people's house, and the people doesn't like me, you know. Sleeping too late, and they thinking I'm no energy to take care of the patient. So I thinking that time I have to, you know, when I use the, you know, open the lights in the room, so the, you know, the patient, you know, start, you know, the employer start, you know, to say something. I don't want them, you know, get upset. Then it's like I thinking, oh, it's better stay in the closet because, you know, for my goal, I have to, you know, the learn English. Otherwise, you cannot, you know, the get in the field. Actually, it's just like every night, maybe 2 hours. Then during the weekend, 2 hours.
Oh, 2 hours.
Yes. During the weekend, I can make friends, talk to the, you know, the go to coffee, you know, make English friends. We talk about English. They teach me how to speak. Yeah. Yes, in the beginning, I just like, I thinking it was hard. So it's a totally different with my, you know, the first job in China, it's like a doctor. But you know that after I'm not the person always give up. I just thinking, I don't want, you know, to show them, you know, the fail about, you know, the my goal. That's why I just like keep going. Yeah, never thinking about you give up. I think it's language. In the beginning, when I came here, the language, you know, the communication with some people, they ask me, I don't know how to answer. I did not even know, you know, the understand. So the English, the language is really, really difficult. Yes, I think so. And because for my job, just like for my career, and I thinking just like use the Chinese medicine and the acupuncture for the people and the same. Just like a speak language, different language problem. And but you know the treatment almost the same because the people they are, you know, they are same. Oh, you know the position, you know the you know, just like the body the same. So we will learn about you know the Chinese medicine. And you know the body, the you know that you have the you know the lines, is the same. So, I think you know that my you know the medicine should be works on the Western also. Difference it's like a work a different way. So Chinese acupuncture works you know that just like open the line, but you know the traditional Chinese medicine work on the body, so you know give your qi energy. You know, the balance your, you know, the body is just like some people temperature is lower, balance that one. But that's for other people, just like combined together, it's really good. And the acupuncture acts on the body is just like open the line. Because people, they get hurt. Also, they get, you know, the some cold air go inside but the body. So the line is was black. And, you know, use the acupuncture to open the line, just like a traffic. You know the traffic man, you know that when the you know traffic it jump, so you know cannot go through, right? And we just use the needles to make the line go through and people get healed better. Yes, because yeah, difficult because you know that you that's why I'm studying you know English hard because we have to talk about you know that when I see the Western people, I need to start from basics, introduce the traditional Chinese medicine with, you know, the how to work in the body and, you know, I have to from basics talk about. But after the people, they are here, then said, oh, it's making sense. Yeah, they are, you know, the suddenly understand. Because of the body, you know, that we balance qi, you know, that we have five, you know, the we have to balance body's qi energy. So sometimes, you know, that if one side is weak, other side is strong, we have to, from, you know, the strong side, you know, balance to another side. So I have to tell the people what kind of problem you have, then how to treat, then they are understand, they accept really well. We have lots of food in China right now. Just like we celebrate New Year and we have to clean our house really, really clean. We just make sure, you know, the last year, the bad things with, you know, just like clean out. And also we you make lots of food, you know, the just cook the dumpling. We eat dumpling during the, you know, the New Year Eve. So we welcome to next year, just like a gold year. It doesn't matter if it's gold or, you know, the pig and, the, you know, the what animals, but, you know, the new year should be give your wellness. And also, the, you know, the case, they can get red envelope. That's meaning is good luck for everybody. Yes.
The glove has changed to everyone. Many years ago, teenagers loved to wear a beautiful t-shirts or amazing pants to conquer the planet. Now, most of them want money. Sadly, the passion for a career is not as before. The only thing is to get a lot of money under any circumstances. When and how can relatives or parents should give money to the younger members of the house? Yolanda Montoya has the answer.
¿Qué tal, amigos? Nuevamente aquí en la revista El Inmigrante, en su sección Salud Mental. Yolanda Montoya con ustedes. El tema de hoy es si es recomendable dar dinero a los hijos desde que son pequeños. Mi opinión muy particular y como profesional es sí. Sí es recomendable darlo, hacerlo, pero hay que saber hacerlo. Hay ciertos pasos a seguir para que esto pueda suceder. Primero que nada, hay que explicarles a los hijos la importancia de ganar el dinero, ya que vivimos en una sociedad que desde hace muchos siglos se maneja como una economía, en una economía monetaria. Por lo tanto, es necesario que ellos aprendan a manejar, a manejarse con el dinero. Importante es el poder explicarles que el dinero no se obtiene fácilmente. Hay que hacer una tarea para obtenerlo. Y para esto es necesario tener reglas en casa y decirles, explicarles que ellos tendrán que ejecutar ciertas tareas para obtener cierta cantidad de dinero, aunque sea pequeñita. No hay que dar mucho dinero tampoco. Para que ellos puedan tener también el hábito del ahorro, será necesario comprarles una pequeña alcancía para que ellos vayan depositando este pequeño dinero, estas pequeñas ganancias que van obteniendo con estos quehaceres en casa. Ahora, es importante que también se les inculque el hecho de que pueden compartir este dinero no nada más para ellos, sino con alguien más, con algunas personas que no tienen los mismos recursos. Es importante tener prioridades de cómo los niños van a gastar su dinero. Es decir, con ellos se les debe de platicar qué es lo que quieren comprarse con este dinero. Es necesario explicarles que no es conveniente gastarlo en el momento en que lo ganan, ir a comprar un dulce o un pequeño juguete, sino que quizás ellos quisieran tener algo más, algún juguete quizás más caro, un videojuego que lleva un poco más de tiempo y requiere de mayor ahorro. Por lo tanto, se les explica que hay cierta necesidad de esperar para poder gastar este dinero. Ahora, una vez que ellos han elegido qué van a comprar, es importante acompañarlos a diferentes tiendas para que vean las diferencias de precios sobre el mismo producto y que encontrarán que en ocasiones el mismo producto pueden encontrar alguna oferta que les cueste un poco más barato. Esto les enseña también a que puedan manejarse mejor con el dinero. Algo que también se debe de mencionar aquí es el hecho de que el portarse bien no está incluido en obtener dinero. A veces los padres les dicen, si te portas bien, terminando te doy dinero, terminando del evento donde vamos, te puedo pagar. No, esto nunca debemos de hacerlo. ¿Por qué? Porque el portarse bien es una parte de la convivencia que ellos deben de aprender en la sociedad. Si ellos necesitan ser pagados para portarse bien, imagínense ustedes qué harán el día de mañana cuando la gente no les pague, pues ¿cómo van a estar inmersos en una sociedad que no les paga por portarse bien? O sea, es simplemente portarse bien es parte de lo que ellos tienen que aprender a comportarse para ser aceptados y convivir en la sociedad común y corriente. Otro aspecto que sería interesante es que cuando los chicos, a veces sucede que estamos en alguna tienda y ellos quieren comprar inmediatamente algo que acaban de ver, suelen pedir prestado. Mamá, préstame, papá, préstame, yo tengo dinero en casa, llegando a casa, yo te lo pago. No, esto no puede ser. ¿Por qué? Porque ellos, si no tienen el dinero en el momento, no pueden comprar lo que ellos quieran, aunque estén con papá y mamá. ¿Por qué? Porque esto les da un aprendizaje. El aprendizaje aquí es, tienen que esperar, es decir, tienen que aprender a esperar para a obtener lo que se quiere. Y esto también ayuda a tener la habilidad o la capacidad de tolerar la frustración de no obtener las cosas cuando se quieren. La vida no es así. Uno no obtiene lo que quiere cuando quiere, sino lo obtiene cuando realmente puede o ha luchado por ello. Por lo tanto, esto, este prestar dinero cuando uno no está en el momento adecuado que ellos traen su dinero, papá y mamá no pueden prestar dinero, no deben prestar dinero a este pequeño, aunque sepan que en casa lo tienen. Bien, por otro lado, es importante que ellos ganen este dinero en casa realizando algunas tareas, como puede ser pues ayudar a lavar los trastos en la cocina, arreglar su cuarto, por supuesto, el cortar el césped, el poder lavar el auto de la familia, en fin, ellos van ganando dinero. Los más grandecitos quizás ya con una edad de 14, 15 años pueden ayudarse y ayudar a vecinos, amigos o a la misma familia, quedándose con los más pequeñitos, cuidándolos y obteniendo un pequeño dinero por esto, es decir, haciendo un poco de babysitter con los pequeños y obteniendo una ganancia por esto. Es importante que cuando los chicos ya son un poquito mayores, se les dé una cantidad específica, ya sea mensual o semanalmente, esto lo decidirán los padres, y habrá que explicarles a los chicos cómo manejarse con este dinero, comprándoles una pequeña libreta en donde se les anote cuáles son sus, las aportaciones que se les dará mensualmente y cuáles serán los gastos que ellos realizarán dependiendo de sus necesidades o lo que ellos gusten gastar. Pero para esto ya deberán de tener un hábito de ahorro. Es necesario también orientarlos cuando son más grandecitos y empiezan con estas edades ya un poquito, digamos, llegando casi a la adultez, en donde pueden ellos obtener algún pequeño trabajo, trabajos por horas, ayudarles a hacer un resumen de su vida para explicarlo cuando tengan una entrevista de trabajo. Es importante orientarlos también de cómo deben presentarse a una entrevista de trabajo, tanto en cuanto a su vestido como en su forma de hablar, el respeto que deben de tener hacia su trabajo, hacia los horarios que se deben de cumplir y hacer lo que se les pida en el trabajo. Hay que ser respetuosos en este aspecto y ellos van adquiriendo esta habilidad. ¿Por qué es importante desde pequeños enseñarles este hábito? Bueno, pues porque cuando se es adulto, ellos ya no tendrán esta dificultad cuando tengan un empleo ya formal, en saber cómo distribuir su dinero, qué hacer, cómo pagar sus gastos, cómo pagar su renta, cómo pagar la luz, cómo pagar el gas, ahorrar quizás para tener un pequeño carrito de medio uso en un principio tal vez, en fin, ellos ya no tendrán esa dificultad. No es que les llegue el dinero de pronto y empiecen a comprar lo que les gusta, ahora quiero una tele, ahora quiero un videojuego, cuando que de pronto se gastaron todo el dinero y terminaron con el mes sin saber que, si van a poder comer o no comer, porque no tienen un hábito ni una responsabilidad de cómo distribuir el dinero que han ganado. Amigos, creo que esto ha sido todo por hoy. Es importante siempre orientar a los hijos, estar con ellos, preguntarles cómo se sienten, darles todas las respuestas a las dudas que puedan tener abiertamente. Y si no se sabe en ese momento, hay que consultarlo y decirle claramente, déjame, no me sé la respuesta por el momento, yo consultaré y te daré una explicación. Mil gracias por su atención. Como siempre, les deseo lo mejor y por acá nos vemos en una siguiente oportunidad.
Indeed, we enjoy doing what we love. Following Jimmy Nuts Magazine's program Philosophy, we enjoy giving you information and orientation. Thank you for giving us this fantastic opportunity for being part of your life and to help you with your rights. Personal Taxes Seminar, next.
We are immigrants, we feel the Canadian system is perfect. It's not, right? So that's why it's important for us to be on top of our game, trying to learn as much as we can. Also, the idea is not get information from our friend, from our cousin. Go directly to the source. If you don't understand something or you want to know exactly what it is, go directly to CRA website or consult a professional, because the only ones who are going to lose money is you. Now, if you are an employee and also provide services, because you provide services independently, you are entitled to file the taxes at June 15th instead of April 30th. If you're just an employee, you have to file until April 30th. Now, nobody dies. It's not a problem if you don't file on April 30th, right? If you have a refund, the government will pay you interest on that amount. If you owe money to the government, they will charge you interest. That's the only thing happened. I've seen people who haven't filed taxes in 15 years. So make sure that if you have more than one job as an employee, they get a little bit extra in taxes, because it could create a problem when you file. Yeah? If you work for only one employee, obviously it'll be the right amount of deductions. So the idea when you file your taxes, depending to what happened throughout the year, is to see, okay, I went to school, I got sick, or I got a very expensive dental treatment and I wanna write it off. Or I move, I came from Toronto to Vancouver because of work or study, I can write off that. So your obligation as a taxpayer is to look for the credits you are entitled in order to get back some of the money you pay in taxes. The nice thing about charity, tuition, medical expenses is that if I'm married or I have a common in-law partner, I can't transfer. The professional, the person who helps you with your taxes, it's really important that they work for you. So let's say I have these three things together. The person who prepared the tax have to make sure that it's maximizing in the taxpayer who's gonna get the most refund, because you can transfer this. For instance, the people who work in construction, because you move from one site to another. You use your vehicle for that. You have to use your cell phone because your employer called you. Okay, listen, you have to show up in this site today, right? You use your vehicle, your cell phone. You have to buy boots. Sometimes you have to buy supplies that you don't get reimbursed, right? So when that happened for the people who work in construction, the employer have to sign a declaration of employment condition. Also, this works for people who work on commission. They have a T4, but part of that earnings is on commissions, right? So if you use some of those things like cell phone, vehicle, home office, or internet, or whatever you need to perform your job, you are entitled to get that form signed, and that allow you to write off all those expenses. Caregiver credit. That is when we live with our older parents or grandparents, and we live in the same roof. Right, and it's a special credit for that. Okay, sole proprietorships. This is for people who run a business, provide services that on their own, that they, let's say, invoice clients, right? But they are not incorporated. So the amount of money they earn throughout the year goes in the personal income tax. That's called a sole proprietorship. You're running that type of business. So one thing that we have to be very careful about partnerships that are not incorporated is that we become responsible for any amount that our partner owe to everyone. So if our partner decides not to pay the car he leased or bought, then we are responsible. So this is the tricky part about becoming partners with someone without being incorporated.
The light is red, our camera is on. behind the scenes. Next.
I'm scared. I'm really scared. Oh, I forget. You know that every Chinese New Year we have fish, because the fish that's meaning you have. You know that every year you have more, more, more.
3, 2, 1, grabando.
Amigos, nuevamente con ustedes, Yolanda Montoya aquí.
Who thinks big is the one who creates the future. Thanks, Wendy Wen Jun, for inspiring us with your amazing story. Remember, the only barrier in your life is you. We're on Facebook, I'm on Twitter. Have a wonderful day. Bye.
Problemas de relaciones interpersonales, separación, divorcio, problemas con niños, adolescentes y adultos.
Soy la doctora Yolanda Montoya, soy Clinical Counselor y mi teléfono es el 604-861-1071.